Hello and welcome again. So while leaving the last session, we finished till up to I think 3.5, and I asked you to do 3.6 of your own and 3.7, 3.8, and I think so even 3.9. If some of you might have tried, that's a good thing, but some of you might have actually confronted some trouble. So that's the reason why actually I'm picking up question number 3.6 to start this particular session. Correct? 3.6. 3.6. Let's begin with this particular question first of all. In this question, there are some interesting points, so you need to just pay attention over here. The first one is that, in this case, Welkin's brother has three departments. Now, for a moment, we may be tempted to think that we may have to prepare three department accounts, actually, garment selling and general administrative department for a while. Quite obviously, when the question is stating that you have got three departments, you need to prepare three departments, no doubt about that. However, further, the story goes like this, that garment transfers its goods to selling department at the rate of profit on cost. Now, in this question, this line needs a little bit of attention, in the sense that whatever goods selling department requires, if you look closely over here into the column of selling department, you find that there are no purchases at all. That means selling department never purchases the goods from outside sources. That means whatever goods it requires, it gets it from what we call garment department. That means all the goods which selling department gets, that is from garment departments. Is it clear to you? So, and garment department transfers goods to selling department at the rate of 20% profit on cost. Second important point is that in this particular question, it is very clearly written that garment department transfers the goods, but how many goods? It is not given to us, correct? From the following details, prepare departmental trading and profit or loss account. Now, only information related to garment in selling department is given. Whereas in the opening line question is stated very clearly that there is garment department, there is selling department, there is general administration department. Below, it is given that during the year, goods costing 50,000 to selling departments were returned back to garment department. We know that so far, as per the story of the question, garment department never sells the goods to the outside sources. It sells whole of its goods at a profit of 20% to the selling department. It is clearly written in the opening lines as we just went through that. Here it is, correct? And whatever goods selling department received this year from the garment department, out of that rupees 50,000 worth of goods have been returned by selling department as per this particular line. Further, now this line is quite important. The expenses of the general and administrative department are as follows. Expenses of general and administrative department. Now we see actually that general administration department is not producing any goods, neither it is selling any goods. It might be giving its services to the other departments. And that is what exactly the administrative department's function is, isn't it or not? So in this particular question, these are the expenses. Manager's salary is 1,000 per month. So quite obviously, manager's salary will be 12,000. There are two clerks, and each clerk is getting 600 per month. If each clerk would get 600 per month, that is the salary per annum of one clerk, 600 into 12, and then I will multiply it with 2. So this will become the total salary of the clerk, 600 per month, that is 7,200 into 2, 14,400, correct? So total salary of two clerks will be equal to 14,400. Maintenance expenses given to you, 9,600 per annum, it is given to you. Now further, the question states that apportion general department expenses. So whatever expenses which took place in the general administrative department will have to be apportioned to these two departments, garment department and selling department. So, and in the ratio and equally, it is very clearly given, equally we have to apportion. That means manager salary will be divided between what we call garment and selling department in the ratio of 1:1, while clerk's salary will also be divided in the ratio of 1:1, and likewise maintenance expenses will also be divided between these two departments. So you can see that in this particular question, only some information with respect to expenses is given with respect to general and administrative department. So we need not require to prepare in this case general and administrative department, because there is no profit at all, and whatever expenses took place in this department have been apportioned to these two departments. That is why we would be preparing in this particular question only garment department and selling department. This is one important point. Second important point is, right, this I have already discussed. And in the opening lines, this line is of $1 trillion, that garment transfers its goods to selling department at the rate of 20% profit on cost. That means garment transfers its goods. That means whatever goods it produces, it simply transfers to selling department at a profit of 20%. And at the same time, selling department never purchases from outside, as we can see from this particular column. Here is blank in the what we call column of selling department. So on such note, now we can begin the solution of this particular question. It is, so I will solve it for you, don't worry about that. And here I write departmental trading and profit and loss account, correct? Departmental trading and profit and loss account. So I will prepare only two departments. One is garment department, another one is selling department. So garment and selling, these are the two departments. And where is the scale? The scale is lying over here. Fortunately, I will stretch a line now. I will stretch another, I think this much is enough. So let's go through the question now. The question states that opening stock as far as is concerned, that happens to be 1,20,000 with respect to garment. Similarly, 80,000 with respect to selling department, correct? Then we have got in this case purchases. Only garment department purchases goods from outside. So purchases are worth rupees 5 lakh. There are no purchases as far as selling department is concerned. Then we have got in this case wages and other expenses. Wages and other expenses. Wages and other expenses are 1,25,000 with respect to this department and 25,000 with respect to selling department. Further in this question, we have been given closing stock. So I write here closing stock. Now closing stock of garment department is 45,000. And closing stock is of 95,000. Further, it is given that sales of selling department, as we have already seen, that garment department never sell the goods outside. Garment department simply is transferring the goods to the selling department. However, sale department will make some sale. When we say sale, it means sale to the outsiders. So 11,05,000 worth of sale has been done by selling department. We know that definitely in this particular question, some goods have been transferred by garment department. But right now we are unaware of the amount of that particular transfer. Further, below it is also given that during the year, goods worth rupees 50,000 have been returned by selling department to the garment department. Unless and until we will have the figure of goods transferred, we will not be able to treat this item. So we leave it as it is for a while. And there are some expenses related to general and administrative department, but these expenses ultimately will be apportioned to these two departments. So that's the reason actually in this particular case, I'm not preparing separately any general administrative department account. So whatever expenses are there, we are now putting them up and apportioning them between these two departments. Manager salary is one. I told you manager salary is given to us as 1,000 per month. So it will be equal to 12,000 per annum. And we will divide it equally. In fact, all the expenses will have to be divided equally in this case. Then clerk salary. We computed clerk salary. One clerk salary will be equal to 600 into 12. Two clerk salary will be equal to 14,400. So 7,200. 7,200. Then we have been given maintenance expenses. I will write here maintenance expenses. 9,600 per annum. So it will be equal to 4,800. 4,800. So we have apportioned now all the expenses. So only thing is that we have to find out now the amount of what we call transfer. So whatever transfer will take place, those transfer will also be written over here on the debit side of the selling department, because department G is the transferor department. Once we shall have that particular figure, then we would be able to find out our gross profit. We will take the gross profit to the credit side, and ultimately we shall find out our net profit. So ultimately, now the crux of this story remaining is that we have to find out at what value goods have been transferred, correct? So at what value goods have been transferred, in order to determine that, what I am going to do, just pay attention, I will make a working note to determine the value. So here is the working note. How will you determine there is a sort of hint given to you that goods transferred by garment department is at 20% profit on cost. That means at least you can find out the total cost of goods sold by department G. Isn't it or not? We can find it out easily. See here. Opening stock is 120,000. So I will write here 120,000. Opening stock is equal to 120,000. I will add to it the purchases. Amount of purchases of department G is equal to how much? That is equal to 5 lakh. So I am going to now add 5 lakh to it. Well, also I will add wages, direct expenses, wages, other expenses. That is equal to 1,25,000. I will add 1,25,000 also, correct? And then I will subtract the closing stock. Opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus this 45,000. So that will deliver me the cost of the goods sold. 1,20,000 plus 5 lakh plus 125 minus 45, that is equal to 7 lakh. So 7 lakh is the cost of the goods produced by us. We can say it this way around also. This is the cost of the goods sold. So we have computed the cost of the goods sold. Whatever goods you produce, their cost must be equal to this much, because you had in the opening at your disposal 1,20,000 worth of goods. You purchased 5 lakh worth of goods, so total now 6,20,000. You incurred this much of expenses, so your cost has gone up to this much, and some of the stock is remaining, so obviously you are going to subtract. So final cost is equal to this much, cost of goods sold. However, all these goods you are going to sell or transfer to other department. So that is why it will be written cost of goods sold. Now you know that goods are being transferred at 20% profit on cost. So I will add 20% profit on cost. So 20% profit on cost. It is clearly given in the question, 20% profit on cost. So I'm going to simply add 20% profit on cost. So 20% profit on cost will be equal to 1,40,000. It means at this value, I must have transferred goods to the other department. This will be known as net transfers. Why I am using the word net transfers, just wait, net transfer at selling price. Why I am using, because some of the goods have been returned, 50,000 worth of goods have been returned. Honestly speaking, you can reflect by way of your note also, just to make the examiner understand that you have picked up the point which was given in the question, because you have to show that you have been able to understand that. That means gross transfers must be equal to this much. 840,000 plus 50,000 returns. First of all, you will add it, because you must have transferred 890,000 worth of goods to department B, and out of that department returned 50,000 worth of goods. And I have already told you, whenever I would write transfer of finished goods, it should be at net value. So 840,000. In fact, when we get through this formula, what we call cost of the goods sold, that is always equal to net value. Is it clear to you? That is never ever at gross value. That's the reason actually this value is considered as net value. So anyway, so in the what we call account, we have to reflect it at 840,000. So one thing we have been able to find out, and that is the most important thing in this particular question, 840,000 worth of goods. And whenever you write here transfer of finished goods, it is always better to mention net, so that examiner understand that you have taken the net value after adjusting the returns. So this 840,000 have been transferred by you and must have been received by other department. 840,000. 840,000. Is it clear to you? So now I am in a position to find out my gross profit. Actually, gross profit is written here over itself. So gross profit as per the solution is 1,40,000. I will simply write here 1,40,000. And gross profit of other department is equal to 2,55,000. 2,55,000. Is it clear to you or not? So it is given to us. Now, we have to find out unrealized profit. In order to find out unrealized profit, this is your working note number one. That is with respect to what we call determination of goods transferred, correct? And working note number two, I will do it here itself just to save the bit of space for me. Actually, in this question, when you will go through the question, some of you might feel that, sir, where it is written that in the stock of so much of margin is there, as it used to be written in other question. That means other questions were quite clear, and it was easy to infer after going through the question that there was case of unrealized profit. In this case, we have been simply given that one department is selling its entire lot of goods or transferring entire lot of goods to the other department. That's all. And it is also given that goods are being transferred at a 20% margin. But you need to pick it up. You need to pick it. Correct? Because you have to read it between the lines in this particular question. Between the lines means very closely you have to go through it. If I'm transferring you whole lot of goods, so whatever opening stock and closing stock is at your disposal, that must be out of the lot transferred by me, because you are not purchasing any goods. What my point is, in earlier questions, it used to be written that in the stock, so much of percentage of the goods comprises of interdepartmental transferred goods. So that is why it was very easy to compute the what we call amount of unrealized profit over there. But in this particular question, it is not specifically given. However, once we grip the crux, then it becomes quite easy. In this case, entire lot to you has been transferred by me. Now, whatever opening and closing stock is at your disposal, it is quite natural then that whatever closing stock or opening stock is at your disposal, it is quite natural then that must be out of the lot which I transferred to you. Because you are not purchasing any goods. That means your 100% of opening and closing stock is nothing but interdepartmental transfer. That is what my point here is. For example, in this case, you are having opening stock, correct? Okay, let's start with closing stock, because generally we have a habit of that and it becomes a little bit easier for you too. So I write closing stock of department. closing stock of department Q. Or department S, sorry, selling department. What is your closing stock? Let's have a look. Your closing stock is 95,000. Here it is, correct? 95,000. Now, if I ask you what proportion of this stock, this is your closing stock, you are department S. So, what proportion of this stock would comprise interdepartmental transferred goods? Interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods will be 95,000. That is what my point is. This entire closing stock will be considered as interdepartmentally transferred goods. The reason being is that entire lot of goods have been transferred by me only. You are not purchasing any item through outside sources. So that is the reason in this case 100% of this will be considered as interdepartmental transferred goods. Now the next question is, what is the profit margin? So profit margin or unrealized profit I can directly compute now. Because it is clearly written in the question, whatever goods have been transferred by me to you is at 20% profit on cost. 20% profit on cost. So unrealized profit will be equal to 20 by 120, not 20 by 100. Because this is the selling price. So I will have to convert the rate which is given on cost into selling price. 20% on cost means cost is 100, margin 20, selling price 120. So 20 by 120 will become your profit margin. I hope now you got it. So now we can find out easily the unrealized profit in it. So your unrealized profit in it will be equal to 15,833. Similarly, you will compute on opening stock. Now, what is your opening stock? Opening stock indirectly means it is your closing stock of last year. So opening stock, anyway, we will look at it in the selling department. It is 80,000. So I will write here 80,000. This is opening stock. So interdepartmental transferred goods out of it. Interdepartmental transferred goods. 80,000. 100% of 80,000. Because all the goods have been supplied by us to you. So whatever closing stock is there, that must be out of our supplies only. So 80,000. Now unrealized profit. 20 by 120 once again. And 20 by 120 will deliver you 13,333 as per your solution. So these are the major points of this particular question. I hope now it is clearer to you. Is it clear to you or not? So in this question, the problem arises over this particular area. So now we can find out our net profit, gross profit. We have already found out. Gross profit is equal to 1,40,000, 2,55,000. Net profit as per the solution is 1,22,000 and 2,37,000. These are formalities now. The major points I have already explained, correct? So now after this, you can prepare your general profit and loss account, general P&L account. In general P&L account, you will write the net profit. Net profit department G, 1,22,000. Department S, 2,37,000. You write your loading or unrealized profit on opening stock. Unrealized profit on opening stock towards the credit side. Why? Because last year it must have been written towards the debit side. Correct? On the presumption that this profit was not realized. However, in the current year, opening stock must have been sold out. Correct? So, we will consider this unrealized profit now realized. Correct? Now, some of you may question me, sir, if it has been realized, then why we are writing unrealized profit? Because we have to close the balance of the unrealized profit which is appearing in our books, correct? So that's the reason. And unrealized profit on closing stock, which we computed, I think it was 15,000 something, 15,833. So then you will compute your net profit. Your net profit will be equal to 365,500. So this is how you are going to compute in this particular case. Correct? Interesting question. I hope so. You must have enjoyed this one. Now let's have a look over this particular question. Even this particular question seems innocuous, seems quite easy, but let's see whether it is really easy or not. In this question, it is written that Kelvin Brothers has two department, department A and B. From the following details, prepare departmental trading account and profit and loss account and general profit and loss account for the year ended so and so. Now in the first line, it is given to us opening stock 70 and 54,000. So directly we start doing the solution. I will simply explain. No solution is given in the question, so I will do the solution for you. 3.7. So 3.7. Correct. So here I write departmental trading and profit and loss account. Departmental trading and profit and loss account for the year ended so and so. There are two departments in this case. One is department A, another is department B. Department A and department B. Obviously, in order to solve the question, I will require the services of a scale and then I will stretch it further. Let's see whether I think this much is enough. Correct? This much is enough. Now we start doing the solution straight away. First of all, we have been given opening stock. I will simply write opening stock. Till up to this stage, there should not be any problem. 70,000 and 54,000. So I will write 74, 54. Correct? Then we have been given purchases. I will simply write here purchases. Amount of purchases given to us in this particular question, 392,000. And 298,000. 298,000. Then we have been given carriage inward. So carriage inward. Carriage inward happens to be your 6,000 and 9,000. After carriage inward, even in this case, there are wages and other expenses. So I will simply write wages. 54,000. Wages is equal to 54,000 and 36,000. Then we have got figures of sales. Sales in department A happens to be 5,72,000. So I shall write here 5,72 and 4,60,000 in the column of B. Now the next important point is with respect to transfers. A question of similar intensity we did earlier, if you remember. Correct? Anyway, so I write here transfers. As far as transfers is concerned, similar to that question, in this case, goods transferred by B to A, department B is transferring but purchased goods. So department B is transferring 50,000 worth of goods. So I will write it towards the debit side, transfer. Then I will write here purchased goods. I will write in the column of A 50,000 because B is the transferer department. So A is the transferee department or the receiving department. Now it is written that A has transferred 36,000 worth of goods. So towards the credit side, I will write in the column of A 36. And towards the debit side in the column of B, I will write 36. This is case of purchased goods. Just after that, transfer of finished goods is given. Now, you have to exercise caution here because In case of finished goods, there are some return also. For example, in case of finished goods, it is given to you that A is transferring, first I am picking up A. A is transferring to B 1,75,000 worth of goods. 1,75,000 worth of goods. Similarly, B is also transferring, and B is transferring to A 1,50,000 worth of goods. Now below it is given that return of finished goods by B to A and by A to B. See, actually A has transferred to B 1,75,000 worth of goods, and out of 1,75,000 worth of goods, B has returned 45,000 worth of goods. So 45,000 worth of goods have been returned by B. So net transfer of finished goods will be equal to 1,30,000. Correct? Similarly, B has transferred 1,50,000 worth of goods, and out of that 32,000 worth of goods have been returned by A. So net transfer will be equal to 1,18,000. 1,18,000. Is it clear to you or not? So when I will write here finished goods, so I will write the net amount. I will write in bracket net to tell to the examiner that we have adjusted the amount of returns. So 1,30,000 and 1,18,000. Then we have, in this case, closing stock. Closing stock is given to us, and closing stock, again, of purchased goods and finished goods separately given. Purchased goods with respect to department A is 24, and finished goods with respect to this department is 1,02,000. While for B, it is 30,000 purchased goods and 62,000 for finished goods, correct? This is what is given to us in this particular question. Further, you are informed that purchased goods have been transferred mutually at their respective departmental purchase cost. And we always know about this particular fact that purchased goods are always transferred at cost price only. We are more concerned with transfer of finished goods. Finished goods are transferred at a margin of 30, sorry, at departmental market price. Now this line is very important in this question. Finished goods are transferred at departmental market price. That means the price which you charge from the other customer in the market. Same price you charge when you transfer the finished goods to the other department. Indirectly, it means you are transferring the goods at market price, means at selling price. That means rate of profit is not given. However, the question which we did of similar what we call characteristic and features, in that actually profit margin was given. In this question, we will have to find out, and we know the trick how to find out. And further question says that 30% of finished goods in the closing stock. See here, in the closing stock, word closing is written. So only in closing stock, we will have to find out the unrealized profit. Is it clear to you or not? So this is the point which is given in this question. So till up to this particular stage, we can find out gross profit. Isn't it or not? Your gross profit will be equal to how much? You will have to find out your gross profit. In this case, gross profit is equal to 1,74,000 as per the net solution. You please also try to calculate it by yourself. And 1,57,000 is gross profit of this department. Obviously, this gross profit, we will take it over here. 1,74,000. 1,57,000. In this question, there are no expenses which will be written in profit and loss account. So that is why my net profit will remain same. 1,74,000 and 1,57,000. This is my net profit. So we have computed the net profit. However, this net profit is subject to the adjustment of unrealized profit. So here I prepared general profit and loss account. In the general profit and loss account, I write here net profit. Net profit of this department A is 1,74,000. And net profit of this department A, this department is equal to 1,57,000. Now only thing remaining is that I have to find out unrealized profit on closing stock. Correct? And this will be considered as unrealized profit of which department? Because this time both the department are transferring. So we will have to find out unrealized profit on closing stock of both the department. How to find out unrealized profit? That is the point here. Correct? For that, obviously I will have to take the help of working note. So I will write here working note. The first thing in the working note which I would do is to find out the margin rates, because margin rate is not given. It is given that we are selling the goods at market price. So margin rates we will have to find out. In order to find out the margin rate, first of all, I write department A. As far as department A is concerned, we have computed the gross profit of this department. 1,74,000 is gross profit. 1,74,000. Now we will see what are the total sales of this department. As far as sale of this department is concerned, 5,72,000 is the sale and transfer of finished goods is 1,32,000. Correct? 1,72,000 and 1,30,000. 5,72,000 is the amount of sale and transfer of finished goods is equal to 1,30,000. This is the formula we use, correct, to compute margin rate. Gross profit divided by sales plus transfer of finished goods. Never write transfer of purchased goods. Then if you want to compute it on percentage basis, you can do so. It will be equal to 24.79% as per the net solution. Correct? 24.79%. You also check it out. And then similarly, we will compute the margin rates. Margin rates in respect of department B. Now the gross profit of department B is equal to 1,57,000. So I shall write here 1,57,000. And similarly, I will take the sales. The amount of sales is 460 and transfer of finished goods is 1,18,000. So I will write here 4,60,000. Plus 1,18,000. And then I would multiply it with 100. So it will deliver me margin rate of B is 27.16%. Of course, this will be considered as rate of margin on sales because below we have written sales. Now we at least we have the margin rate. And finally, now we are in a position to find out unrealized profit. So what will be my unrealized profit? See here. After having found out margin rates, now we can find out unrealized profit. In order to find out unrealized profit, I write department A and department B. Number one. Number two, I will write closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods. Now, closing stock of finished goods. What is the closing stock of finished goods with department A? In fact, we have written it over here. 1,02,000 and with department B, it is 62,000. So, 1,02,000 and 62,000 is the closing stock of respective department. And this time question is categorically stated that 30% of the finished goods in the closing stock correct, constitutes the goods from the other department. So I will write here 30% interdepartmental transferred goods. In the last question which I did, I wrote 100% because whole lot was actually transferred by us. But here, in the closing stock, only 30% proportion comprises of the goods transferred by the other department. So interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods is equal to 30%. So I will compute 30% of this figure first of all. So 1,02,000 into 30% will be equal to 30,600. So out of 1,02,000, 30,600 worth of goods will be considered as interdepartmental transferred goods. Likewise, out of 62,000 into 30%, 18,600 will be considered as interdepartmental transferred goods. Important point which you should not let it skip out of your mind is that these goods which are available with A must have been transferred by department B. And similarly, these 18,600 worth of goods must have been transferred by department A. So now we are in a position to find out unrealized profit. Because I have to find out unrealized profit on 30,600, so what rate should I apply? Obviously, these goods have been transferred by department B, so that is the reason actually I am going to apply 27.16%. This is important point. Similarly, these goods 18,600 must have been transferred by department A, and you are going to apply this rate 24.79% to know the amount of unrealized profit. So according to the net solution, it is unrealized profit of department A is actually, let me see whether they have done it correctly, 30,600 into 20, right, correctly, 8311. We are not checking our solution, we are checking their solution. And similarly, 18,600 into 24.79, it's fine, so 4611. So these are the unrealized profit. When you will write in general profit and loss account, unrealized profit in closing stock of department A, department A is equal to 8311 and of department B is equal to 4611. Now you can compute your net profit, whatever it is. Balance carried down. So balance carried down figure is not given. That will be equal to this much. 1,74,000. Plus 1,57,000 minus 8311 and minus 4611. Total balance carried down is 318,078. Is it clear to you or not? So this is how you will have to do. So in this question, there is what we call treatment with respect to closing stock. I hope now this point, particular point, should be absolutely clear. When you have to take the unrealized profit on opening stock and when not. 3.8, yet another question I asked you to attempt by yourself, correct? 3.8. In 3.8, it is given interdepartmental transfers once again. Again, here you will have to compute on opening and closing stock. Messrs. T485 and company, it looks like a name of a tank rather than a company, but anyway, Messrs. T485 company has two department. One is finished leather department and another is shoes department, correct? The shoes are made by firm itself. That means I am the leather department. I will transfer leather to you. Quite obviously, out of leather received from us, you are going to transform it into shoes and then you are going to sell it. So the shoes are made by firm itself out of leather supplied by leather department at normal selling price. These are the lines which you have to pay attention to. At normal selling price, leather department is the transferor department. So again, you will have to find out the selling price, correct, of the leather department to find out your unrealized profit. From the following particulars, prepare departmental trading and profit and loss account. So this type of question you can manage very easily. Opening stock is given in this particular question. I need not require to talk about it. Opening stock. Then we have been given purchases, sales, and here it is given transfer to shoes department. So you have transferred 30 lakh worth of leather to the shoe department, and manufacturing expenses in your case it is zero because you are not manufacturing at all, correct? Shoes are being manufactured by the other department, so manufacturing expenses are there, selling expenses, then rent and warehousing, and then closing stock of the department is also given to you. In addition to the above, the following information is made available for the necessary information. In the last session, when I went through this particular question, even at that time, I mentioned this particular point that this time it here written that the stock, whenever it will be written only the stock, that means you will have to now do adjustment to opening and closing stock of the other department. That means you have to find out unrealized profit on opening and closing stock both. In the shoe department, here it is written, in the shoe department, may be considered as 75% of leather. The stock in the shoe department may be considered as consisting of 75% of leather and 25% of other expenses. We are least bothered about the expenses. We are bothered about the fact that what proportion of your stock comprises of the goods transferred by us. So it is very simple in this case. Now we have done so many questions, it should be almost like a child play for you. For example, you have the closing stock, correct? This is your closing stock. First of all, in the closing stock, I will compute 75%. What will be 75%? That will be equal to 375,000. That means 375,000 will be considered as interdepartmentally transferred goods. Now, I will have to apply the margin rate to find out unrealized profit. Margin rate I will have to compute in the current year. In the current year, I will have to compute. Now, as far as opening stock is concerned, when I will compute unrealized profit on opening stock, again I will take 75%. 75% of 430,000, whatever it is, I will compute, correct? And I will apply the margin rate. The margin rate of last year is given to you 15%. So whatever closing stock will be, sorry, whatever 75% of 430,000 will be there, you will apply 15% rate to it to get your unrealized profit on opening stock. Now you have to find out unrealized profit on what we call closing stock. First, you will take 75%, it will be equal to 375. You will determine the margin rate by dividing gross profit by figure of sales plus transfer of finished goods. Transfer of finished goods. You can easily find out the margin rate. I think you can manage this question. However, it's still just we will have a cursory look. So here it is. 30 lakh, 4 lakh 30 opening stock purchases, and then manufacturing expenses, and then sales, closing stock 12 lakh 25 lakh. And regarding transfers, 30 lakh worth of goods have been transferred by department, leather department. It will be written over the credit side and towards the debit side of this particular department. Selling expenses, rent and warehousing, and so much. You have computed the gross profit. Now the major question is that we have to find out the margin rate. Your margin rate with respect to department margin rate, with respect to leather department, because leather department is transferring the goods. So 42 lakh. See, figures are in lakh only, so I will simply write 42 lakhs. Correct? You can write entire 42 lakh. I'm just because of space. 42 lakh. And sales is equal to 180 lakhs plus transfer. Quite obviously, whenever in the question it will be simply given to you as transfer, it automatically means you are transferring finished goods. So plus 30 lakhs. in 200, this way round you can compute the what we call margin rate. When you will compute the margin rate, your margin rate will be equal to 20%. 42 divided by 210 it is, that is why I am saying 20%. So very simple now, correct? If you are going to apply 20% to 375,000, I think it will be equal to 75,000, 37,500, right? Unrealized profit will be 75,000. And unrealized profit, 75% of 430,000, first of all, you will compute. Opening stock is 430,000 into 75%, that comes to 322,500. And last year profit margin rate is 15%, so you will compute 15% of it, that will be equal to 48,375. So you have computed now the required things. So you will write here, see, stock reserve on opening stock we have written over here, and 75,000 that is stock reserve or unrealized profit are one and same thing, correct? Then net profit we have transferred, and general expenses are there also, 8,50,000. This is how you are going to get what we call this amount. Is it clear to you or not? So I hope your efficiency must have increased by leaps and bounds. And now we will go through the last question of this particular section. Remember one thing, this happens to be the most formidable section. And you must have got a bit of what we call hint that why it is a formidable section. Especially questions wherein we need to compute and find out unrealized profit on both opening and closing stocks of late are actually embracing the what we call examination papers. Here, following balances were extracted from the books of Beta Limited, and you are required to prepare departmental trading account and general profit and loss account. Let's see whether there is anything which I need to do here. Opening stock, closing stock, it should be child play for you. Purchases and then sales. Respective information you are going to furnish here. General expenses incurred for both the departments were ₹7,50,000, and you are supplied with the following information. General department, it is given that you have incurred 7,50,000. If question does not provide you any clue how to distribute it, it is always better to take the general expenses in the general profit and loss account rather than dividing. Otherwise, on a suitable basis, you can divide. You can divide them equally also in this case. But it is always better to take them to the general profit and loss account. Now, question states that closing stock of department A is 6 lakhs. This is important line. Closing stock of department A is 6 lakhs. So first of all, you are going to write closing stock in department A. However, it states that including goods from department B for 1,20,000 at cost to department A. Just to confuse you, this figure, this point here means that whatever closing stock was with you, closing stock of department A, closing stock of department A is equal to 6 lakhs. Correct? Closing stock of department A is equal to 6 lakh. Just wait it. Out of this, including goods from department B, that means this closing stock basically includes interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods. You have received the goods from Mr. B. Quite obviously, because B has transferred goods to you and you are the receiving department, it will be considered at cost from your perspective because you are the receiver. Suppose if this pen, correct, cost me ₹100, correct, and I sell it to you for 150, for me selling price will be 150. But you are paying 150 for this pen, it will be considered as cost price from your perspective. Similarly, whatever goods have been transferred from the receiver department's point of view, it is at cost. This line is just to confuse us. So, 6 lakh is closing stock, including goods from department B for ₹1,20,000 at cost to department A. It is at cost to department A, but from the perspective of department B, it is at selling price. Correct? So, in usual manner, we will have to apply the margin rate on sale to it. Similarly, it is written that closing stock. Now, closing stock or department B is given to you as 12 lakh. First of all, you will write 12 lakh over here. Then later on, when you will do the working to find out your unrealized profit, this time it states that out of 12 lakh, 1,80,000 worth of goods have been received from department A. These goods have been transferred by department B, and these goods have been transferred by department A. Correct? So these goods are actually at selling price. Actually at selling price from the perspective of the sellers or the transferers. Similarly, question also states that opening stock of department A and department B includes goods of the value of ₹60,000 and ₹90,000 taken from department B and department A respectively. Now see here, in this question you will have to find out unrealized profit both on closing stock and opening stock, because question has given information in a clear-cut manner. So you will write opening stock of department A and B. Correct? Now I look into the opening stock. The figures of opening stock given to us is equal to 3 lakh for department A and for department B it is 2,40,000. Even in opening stock there are some interdepartmental transfer goods. Interdepartmental transfer goods in opening stock, interdepartmental transferred goods. Interdepartmental transferred goods. Question states that opening stock of department A and department B includes goods worth ₹60,000 and ₹90,000 taken from department B. That means opening stock of A includes ₹60,000 worth of goods. And 90,000 worth of goods taken from department B and department A respectively. Quite obviously, these goods must have been transferred by A and these goods must have been transferred by B. This is the question. The gross profit margin is uniform from year to year. What does it mean? See, actually, first of all, in this question, I will compute the gross profit margin. And you know how to compute the gross profit margin. For example, first of all, we will write here, and we will also write here transfer of, see here, finished goods in the current year. It is clearly given that department A has transferred, and moreover, you can look here, what you have transferred 1,80,000 worth of goods. So you will write in column of A, and the same figure 1,80,000 will be written over here. Because A has transferred 1,80,000 worth of goods, this will be written towards the debit side of B. And B has transferred 1,20,000 worth of goods, so B will write it over the credit side and towards the debit side we will write. Correct? Then I will compute here the gross profit. After having computed the gross profit, there are no expenses. It will be my net profit also. Now we come over to this particular fact. I need to find out the what we call margins, and I need to find out margin rate only once. For example, a gross profit rate of department A, let us say, includes goods worth ₹60,000 taken from B. Now gross profit rate, this is of department B, I think. Gross profit 44, this is, I will compute the gross profit margin rate. Gross profit margin rate separately for you so as to not to get confused. See, it is always better whenever margin rates are not given to compute them first. For example, in case of department A, your margin rate will be equal to 24,60,000 gross profit divided by sales. Sales is equal to 60 lakhs plus transfer of goods 1,80,000 and into 100. This is of department A. Similarly, gross profit margin rate or simply margin rate of B will be equal to 44,40,000 is your gross profit. Sales is equal to how much? Sales is equal to 90 lakhs. Sales is equal to 90 lakhs. And then transfer of goods is equal to 1,20,000. Pretty high figures. So you have computed the gross profit margin rate. Gross profit margin rate for department A is coming to, let me check whether these rates have been correct. It is written 27 lakh. No, let me check it out. Four zeros. Okay, I will. It seems there is some calculation mistake in the solution. Let me check it up here. Correct? So 24,60,000. 24,60,000 divided by 61,80,000. In 200, it is equal to 0.39%. Gross profit rate of A is 24,60 lakh divided by 1,80,000. Let me check it up once again. 24,60 divided by 60 lakh sales plus 1,80,000. So that will be equal to 2460 divided by 61,80,000 into 100. That is coming to 39.81%. That means you will consider this rate 39.81%. Actually, rate is correct, but they have written figures. I think in your notes the figures will be okay. So rate is given correctly. So 39.81% is of A, and of B it will be equal to 48.68. But let me check it also. I don't want to take any risk. We have done this section so well, so why to spoil with the last question? So let me just check it down also. 44,40,000, and it will be equal to this much. 44,40 trip figures are pretty high. 44,40,000 divided by 91,20,000 in 200. That comes to 48.68%. Your rates are correct, actually. So rates are correct. That means if I want to find out my margin rates, if I want to find out unrealized profit, first of all, let me know from you. This is closing stock of A. It includes interdepartmental transfer goods of 1,20,000. These goods have been transferred by department B. So you will have to pick up the rate of department B. And department B rate is equal to 48.68. So you will apply 48.68% to find out the amount of unrealized profit of this. Similarly, these goods have been transferred by department A and the rate is 39.81%. 39.81%. Correct? So if you will apply this rate, I will tell you the amount of unrealized profit closing. A will be equal to, again, I do not want to take the risk. Let me check it out. 1,20,000 into 48.68%. 58,416. It is correct. 58,416. It will be considered as unrealized profit of department B because these goods have been transferred by department B. And it will be considered as 71,658. You will write it unrealized profit to the debit side of general profit and loss account on closing stock. Department A's unrealized profit is this much, B's is equal to this much. Similarly, now you will compute your unrealized profit on opening stock. Opening stock is this much. These goods, 60,000 worth of goods, are interdepartmental transferred goods, and these are transferred by department B. So you are going to apply the rate of B. So 48.68%. An amount will be equal to 29208. This will be unrealized profit of department B on opening stock. Similarly, here you are going to apply rate 39.81%. 39.81%. An amount will be equal to 35,829. So, even though question is not tough, but you have to be careful while computing the rate. So, this is interesting question, isn't it or not? However, if in your notes, well, 99.99% in your notes, it will be in a rectified manner. But still, gross profit rate of department B, actually we are computing. So, 44 lakh 40, 90 lakh plus 1 lakh 20. This is correct. This one is correct. 48.68% of department B. And of department A, actually some mistake. It seems some mistake is there. They have committed. We have solved the question. Don't worry about that. 24 lakh 60. Here it is written 27 lakh 60. 24 lakh 60. Divided by 60 lakh plus 1 lakh 20,000. And it is correct. So with that, we come to the end of this particular section. Correct? And moreover, below I have explained it further. And now the next section is equally important. Section 3 and 4 are quite wide. Honestly speaking, every section, every bit is important, but these are quite vital questions. You must have noticed that even in section 4, lots of questions we have included. Lots of questions in section 4, correct? And these questions deal with managerial commission. And questions on managerial commission are not easy, honestly speaking. So a bit of attention is always required at this level. So in the upcoming session, we'll pick up this one. So till then, it's goodbye.